We'll get an update on the rescue efforts in the massive landslide that hit Mako in Davao de Oro. That left 7 dead and dozens missing. We'll be speaking now with Edward Makapili. He is the executive assistant of the Davao de Oro Public Information Office. Mr. Makapili, good afternoon to you. Thanks for joining us today and welcome to the program.
Yes, thank you so much.
Yes, hi, Mr. Makapili, are you with us already? Okay, there you go.
Yes.
Kamusta na po ang sitwasyon dyan?
Well, as of now, the rescue and retrieval operation resumed this morning around 8:30. Yesterday po, napastop siya around 4 o'clock due to bad weather condition kasi po pumasok na naman po ang truck of LPA.
Mm-mm.
But yesterday, before the order of truce or seizure of the retrieval operation, there was about 7 bodies recovered, dead bodies, and 31 injured persons, and about 48 missing. But this morning, as of 10 o'clock in the morning, after the resume of the retrieval operation, umabot na po sa 90 yung missing individuals.
90, sorry to cut you there. How many again?
90 na po yung missing individuals from 48 to 90.
90 as in 90?
Yes po, 90.
All right, go ahead. You were saying 90 missing individuals. Do you have a general idea where they could be?
Well, definitely they're still under the soil that in which the huge portion of lands in the mountain bumagsak. That majority of those from residents of Barangay Masara and allegedly 27 of those from the employees of Apex Mining, yung sakay po ng bus na naka-standby waiting for other employees to arrive kasi po yung shifting na yun patapos na. And then there are others allegedly na missing pa din na part of those natabunan sa landslide.
When I asked you where you if you knew generally, you know, if you had an idea, a general idea where they at, of where the missing could be located, understandably they're under the rubble, right? They're under the soil. But
yes,
a general idea, kasi pag naglandslide po, hindi po ba, hindi mo naman talaga masasabi kung saan, pero na pinpoint
yes,
nyo na ho ba kung saan yung location where they could probably be.
That is the very reason why our rescuers very careful in digging the soil because they cannot really identify in what particular area of the landslide area nung tinambakan na lupa kung nasan nandun pa ba yung
Mr. Makapili. Can you just repeat it again? You were saying that this is the very reason why the rescuers can't identify. Go ahead. You were saying.
Yes. Hindi po na. That is very reason why hindi po mapabilis yung pag dig ng soil kasi the rescuer itself hindi nila alam kung saan banda yung mga tao na natabunan. Because you are right. Na pagbagsak ng lupa, hindi naman talaga sila doon nagstay kung saan sila natatayo. There was a movement due na nadadala sila doon sa pag-movement ng lupa. So, yun po ang dahilan na hindi kasi pag ginamitan natin ng heavy equipments yan, hindi natin alam kung tao na yung tatamaan ng blade ng backhoe or payloader. So, it's a combination of the using heavy equipments and manual operation gamit yung mga pala at ano pa sa pag-didig ng soil para mag-recover yung mga nabiktima.
Do you have any idea or is there any data coming from the field as to how thick the mud or the soil has been? Gaano po kakapal ito pong tumabon dito po sa mga nawawala hanggang ngayon?
Yes, exactly. Kung pagbabasehan po natin yung building ng barangay hall, natabunan yun sa laki ng bukid, estimated po ng ating mga rescuer na sa mga dalawang palapag po ng building ang tumambak po doon sa landslide area.
Two stories high.
Yes po, it appears that way.
Right, and that gives that gives you an idea of how massive the undertaking will be to rescue those who are still missing. What is hampering the search and rescue efforts now? Are you even hopeful that you can still find survivors, Mr. Makapili?
Yes, ma'am. Even the governor and the command incident commander, si Congressman Attorney Well, Peter Gonzaga and Governor Justice Dorothy Gonzaga, they're still hopeful, and even the rescuers, that they're still the victims are still alive. Because yesterday, the last person that was being rescued, he was under the land for 11 hours, and lumabas siya doon, nahukay siya, wala man ng injury. So chances are, especially those people in the bus, kasi naman hindi naman pumasok yung lupa sa bus, no? They're still hoping na marami pa ding buhay.
So parang you're sort of relying that there may be some air pockets there, na may, they're within the structure naman because they were on board that bus.
Yes, I believe in that.
Ilan ho bang bus ito? Isa lang?
Dalawa po, ma'am. Yung isang bus nasa 27 yung sakay, na while waiting for the others employees to arrive, and the other one is 17, 24 and 17.
Of course, you know, you're not just looking at this, you know, tragedy in terms of rescuing those who are still missing. Pero tinitingnan niyo rin ho ba kung bakit nangyari to? Paano humantong sa ganito?
Many people allege that it might be attributed to mining operation, but as the analysis provide, and even my opinion, it cannot be attributed to mining operation. It's because hindi naman po ang tunnel ang nag-bar down, it's the outer part of the mountain yung bumigay. If you will remember, nagkaroon po ng shoreline ang Mindanao, very affected in Davao de Oro. And then, nung nahinto yung shoreline, after 10 days, pumasok yung trout of LPA, in which there is a bigger volume of water for 6 days. Kaya nga, nabalita na lumubog yung maraming bayan sa Davao de Oro and part of Davao del Norte. As the analysis provide, the soil of the mountain na absorbed the water, even though natapos na yung trout of LPA for 6 days, but under of the soil still pasang-basa pa din. So those are the matter of analysis na nakita nila, kaya bumigay yung lupa.
Mm-hmm. And this area where the landslide happened, has that been hazard mapped?
Again po?
Yung area po kung saan nangyari yung landslide, na hazard map na ho ba yan ng DENR? At sinabi ho ba sa inyo na it is safe for occupancy?
Well, I do not know, but the mere fact that the MGB provides the permit and the MGB did not warn any residents there, I believe there's already a precaution given. Perhaps it is a safe, kasi maraming taon na din nakatira doon yung mga residente doon.
Meron ho bang abiso galing sa DENR na
ang pagtira nila?
Or meron ho bang abiso na medyo delikado yung area na yan, mag-ingat dahil merong low pressure area or may shear line? May ganun ho ba?
I believe there is a warning to them. But the situation kasi sa Barangay Masara, the Barangay Masara kasi is an, the whole area of Barangay Masara is an mining site of Apex Mining Corporation. And being a large scale mining corporation, it always follows and implement the protocols provided by the MGB. So I believe that they complied everything, and even the safety declarations from the MGB, that's the reason na maraming nakatira doon.
So pag ganun ho ba, inaasa nyo na lang doon sa mining company at doon sa MGB, wala nang puwang para sa pakikialam ng LGU?
Meron naman po, kasi continuous naman po ang monitoring dyan sa Provincial Mining Regulatory Board. The mere fact that there was no warning given, kasi nga after the trout, mga 6 days na pong walang ulan at mainit na. So nobody expected na mangyayari pa yan. But I believe there is no lapses in the part of the MGB, there's no lapses in the part of the provincial government because the Provincial Mining Regulatory Board continues its monitoring, especially on those times na nagkaroon ng drought of LPA and the shorelines.
And do you think that after this tragedy, protocols will change? How do you avert such an incident from happening again? How do you avoid it from incidents like this from ever happening again, Mr. Capili?
Well, I believe the provincial government will just rely also on the recommendation of the NGB and DNR. Kasi po kung titingnan natin yung Apex Mining, hindi mo malalaman kung baguhan ka dyan, hindi mo malalaman na isang mining area pala yan because Apex is taking care of the environment. Kung papasok ka dyan, makikita mo yung mga bun...
Mr. Capili? Mr. Capili?
Yes, hello.
Yeah, go ahead
malalaki
po.
Malalaki yung mga kahoy at hindi mo masasabi na mining area unless makikita mo yun na may mga dump truck, may heavy equipments lumalabas doon sa bundok na yun kasi nga may tunnel na. So maganda yung pagkaalaga ng api.
Mr. Capili?
Yes, ma'am. Sorry po, may mga inmate tumatawag na interrupt po. So ganyan po. Yes po, go ahead.
Yeah, so ang sinasabi niyo maganda naman ang pag-aalaga sa kalikasan.
Yes po. Yes po.
Mm-mm. So pagkatapos po na nangyari itong trahedyang ito, what is the local government thinking about this particular area? Ano pong gagawin na?
I believe the governor will just wait the recommendation of the NGB. And perhaps the provincial government will also ask the Apex Mining to implement some mitigating programs to prevent another incident and not to compromise.
Mr. Capili?
Yes.
Not to compromise. Go ahead.
Not to compromise the safety of the residents and the employees. So that largely depends on the recommendations of the NGB. And of course, at the part of the local government, provincial government, maybe the provincial government will ask the Apex Mining Corporation to implement some meeting programs to prevent another incident.
Okay, we're going to have to leave it at that. Edward Macapili there, the executive assistant of the Davao de Oro PIO Public Information Office. Thanks again for joining us this noon.